Alrighty, Aquarius, so this is going to be a reading for March 2019. Thank you guys so much for watching this. If you are new to my channel, please make sure you do hit that subscribe button so that you can stay up to date with my messages in the future. Also, make sure you do check out my description box as well if you do want a personal reading. My website is www.mysticalcrystals.com, guys, alright? So let's go ahead and get into this. I don't know if I said this already, but it's going to resonate for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus Aquarius. Well, so what's going on, my Aquarius, for March 2019? Ten of Pentacles wanted to show itself. So I feel like some of you guys are really going to be taking the time to focus on your home life, putting things in place when it comes to finances as well. Buying a new home, where you're going to get that sense of stability from, all of that stuff is on your mind this month, okay? And it could be bringing a level of anxiety because you do want things to be fair. You do want things to be right. And you may be feeling like, you know, you're going through a karmic cycle or whatnot, but let's lay these cards out. So the energy surrounding your relationships for this month, your work life, and family. The information needed for your love life, work life, and family. And the guidance for your love life, work life, and family. All right. And give me one card for the theme for my Aquarius for March 2019. The death card. Okay. So the energy is a death card. And I did do a weekly reading for you guys. I believe it was the last week of February, where you guys, like, the last reading was saying basically you guys are not going to recognize yourself. So I'm already seeing how this reading is kind of reflecting what I saw in the other reading. But with the death card, this is all about transformation, like on a deep, deep, deep level. Like, this is something that you can't even really see until it takes place within you. Then you start seeing the real shift outwardly, as above, so below, right? So it happens within, then you see the physical changes kind of manifest after the transformation. I cannot talk. The transformation takes place internally, okay? Let me get my words together for this reading. But what I am seeing here before we start, with the King of Swords at this bottom of the deck, it's letting me know that you guys are really going to be standing in your power as far as facing your truths, facing the truth of the matter this month, okay? In every aspect, in any facet of your life, all right? So the first card here, we do have the Three of Wands energy, and it's clarified by the Eight of Swords. And this is going to represent your love life, the energy surrounding your love life for this month. So with the Three of Wands, it's all about trying to plan for the long term, also waiting for some changes to come in for the better in the long term, okay? So some of you guys may be in a space of waiting for some new love partners coming in, maybe some new love potential, all right? But you may be in a space of not really putting yourself back on the market or even just being able to see them, like seeing the potential love partners, because you're not like trying to. With the Eight of Swords, this is like self-pity, being in a space of feeling like you're trapped to a circumstance or a negative mind frame, but having more than enough power to get yourself out of it. So what you guys do need to realize when it comes to your love life is this is all about you guys needing to see what you have around you or who you are as a person, all right? And what I am seeing for the energy surrounding work, I do have the Five of Wands clarified by the Knight of Wands. So when it comes to work, I feel like there may be a level of conflict or competition. I will say that. There may be competition for some of you guys, especially if you are trying to get a new position or if you're trying to get like a raise, or some of you guys, there may be like actual coworkers who have issues with you, or some of you guys may be having internal conflict about whether or not you want to stay at a job or continue doing something. Okay, with the Knight of Wands, this is hot and cold energy, not really being consistently passionate about something. So this may be an internal thing going on with you guys, or because of the conflict at work, you may be having that issue with being consistently passionate for what you do as well. Okay. Yeah, and then we have the Five of Wands at the bottom of this deck as well. So major conflict here when it comes to that, whether that's internal or outward. Okay. But what I am seeing for family's energy for this month, I do have the Queen of Swords clarified by the Two of Cups. So there is a chance for you guys to get balance in the family department, okay? But this is all about you guys getting balance within yourself first. Also looking at the truth of the matter here, okay? Because with the Devil card at the bottom of the deck, this is like toxic thinking patterns, a toxic way of handling situations as well. Or even being tied to your family in a negative sense. But what needs to happen here is there needs to be balance within somebody as far as their energies. And it looks like you guys. So getting that balance first before you guys do confront your family for some truths, or maybe to speak to them and get things in order, you're going to have to gain this balance internally. Alrighty, so what I am seeing for the information needed when it comes to love, I do have the Knight of Pentacles clarified by the High Priestess. So when it comes to love, you do need to make sure that you're moving slowly with the partners that you do meet, or the people that you are wanting to, you know, potentially see where things can go. Make sure that you're gathering enough information before you just hop on this, you know, relationship train, all right? Because you just want to make sure there's no secrets. Make sure that you're also just gathering key important details when it comes to this person. See if this person is going to fit who you are as, you know, a person and what you're trying to do in the future here. Especially if you do have a lot of options presenting itself to you. Or if there's like somebody presenting themselves and it may be a little cloudy, you want to make sure that there is no illusions that you're kind of falling into as well. With the High Priestess and the Seven of Chalices. Alrighty, so what I am seeing for the info needed regarding work, we do have the Page of Pentacles clarified by the Six of Wands. So what you do need to know for work is that there is an opportunity for you guys to start like a new job. I feel like if you guys also have an idea for a new business or a new job that you do want to start, or a new direction you want to go in financially, there's a chance for you to get success in that. It's just a matter of which way you're going to go about this, or, you know, if you're going to go ahead and embark on it. Because some of you guys, you're in a space of wanting to take that next step, but needing to know which way to go about it. So make sure you are finding out more information when it comes to whatever you are wanting to do here. Alrighty, and the info that you do need to know regarding your family life, I do have the Seven of Swords clarified by the Page of Pentacles. So for some of you guys, you may be in a space of avoiding your family because you want to put things in place financially. For others of you, you may feel as if you want to avoid them because they may ask you for money. For others of you, this may be a space of you just feeling like they don't have much to even offer you and you just want to focus on yourself, which sounds really messed up to say, but somebody's going to be like, yeah, that is how I feel. All right. But yeah, some of you guys, you're just going to focus on yourself. Others of you also may be avoiding the chance to even work things out. So if you do want to fix things, make sure you're not even just avoiding family altogether, because there may be an opportunity to fix things. Okay. But moving forward, the guidance I can give you guys when it comes to your love life, I do have the Fool card clarified by the Death card. So I feel like you guys do need to go in a new direction here. And before you go in this new direction, it's going to be some internal shifts or some actual shifts that do need to take form at this moment, especially if you've been hurt for some time and dealing with some really hurtful situations here where people played mind games or you just couldn't take it anymore because you were dissatisfied. I feel like now it's time for you to get out of that feeling of lack and go out there and get new love, get new energy sparked in that area of your life. And the guidance I can give you when it comes to your work life for the month of March, I do have the Seven of Wands clarified by the Queen of Pentacles. So when it comes to work this month, what's going to be important is you guys are going to have to stay diligent. You're going to have to stay strong no matter what obstacles, no matter what's being thrown at you. All of these challenges you can face, all of these obstacles you can get past. It's a matter of how hard you're going to fight and whether or not you're going to give up, okay? And it looks like you guys can get some really grounded energy going here. It's just a matter of, like I said, you guys staying focused and pushing for this balance, okay? And what I am seeing for the helpful advice I can give you guys when it comes to family, we do have the Ace of Pentacles clarified by the Queen of Cups. And we do have the Ace of Pentacles at this deck or at the bottom of this deck as well. So that's cool. So when it comes to family, like I said, there is an opportunity for you guys to fix things, to get some stable energy going there, all right? Definitely an opportunity. But it's a matter of confronting your feelings, your emotions about what you do not like, or expressing your feelings to your family, expressing your feelings to the person who you have kids with, maybe, if this is not speaking of, you know, family members. But being in touch with your emotions and actually expressing them in a healthy way. All right, so that you guys can fix these issues here. But overall, this month looks great for you guys. I really wish you guys the best of luck. Okay, if you do need a personal reading, that information is going to be in the description box. And I will talk to you guys in your weeklies. I really, really, really hope you guys enjoy this month. And yes, bye guys.